Mike Hosking Breakfast, 6 to 9 weekdays on Newstalk ZB.
Andrew Seville with us and Guy Heveldt as well. Morning to you both.
Good morning.
And do you know where Guy is, Andrew?
He's not in Tokyo yet.
No, he's not.
He's approximately a metre and a half away from Mr. Hosking.
Oh.
Just come on.
Did I miss the memo? Am I not allowed in there?
Well, Andrew, you might remember a few weeks ago there was a little wager on this show around whether a certain Tokyo Olympics was going to go ahead.
Here we go. Guy, what do you reckon? You want to put some money on the Olympics being cancelled?
I was wondering when you were going to bring this up.
I am increasingly convinced the Japanese are going to pull the pin.
Right, we'll put dinner on it.
There it is. So dinner. So I owe you dinner. You think?
Well, but I've actually brought you in a little something that I think will be brought in at some stage, maybe in the next few seconds.
Hey, Mike, I was alerted to some audio not long after last week's segment of you questioning my cooking ability.
Oh, did I?
You certainly did, and you were very, very doubtful of
that
what
you could
I might
cook.
Be able
I said you'd have takeaways. I said you wouldn't cook; you'd do takeaways. Am I wrong on that, Guy?
You are very wrong.
Oh, my God. Did you make this?
I did make this. This recipe comes from a lovely woman in the hut, Anne Wanden. So if you've got any issues with it, you can bring it up with her. It is a bacon and leek tart.
How is it you... listen to Andrew dribbling. Listen, he's going, bacon and leek tart. Oh, I love a bacon and leek tart. What's Anne Wanden got to do with it? Do you just accept recipes from people in various parts of the country?
Girlfriend's nana.
Say no more. Say no more.
What initial reaction?
It's beautiful.
Thank you very much.
And you swear on cross your heart, hope to die, you did it.
I did everything, start to finish, Mike. Finished it this morning for you. Got
did
up nice
you
and
do
early.
Some, did you
is
do
it,
some?
Is it still warm? Does it have
warm.
Some chutney on the side?
Doesn't need chutney,
doesn't
Andrew.
Doesn't need any accoutrements, Andrew. It's just a superb piece of cooking.
I reckon, I don't live far from the studio. I reckon if I chuck the trainers on, I could be up there at the ad break.
Go on then.
Go for gold. You got about 12 minutes. Did you do any trial versions of this? Or is this?
I've made it a couple of times.
Right.
So would you usually I've had help, I'll be honest.
Was this
this was completely a solo effort
by yourself. Absolutely fantastic. And so you didn't do any warm-ups on this. You only used your previous experience, and this was a one-off. You set out, you made it, and this is what's come out of it.
100%
absolutely
correct.
Spectacular. You've got to be pleased with that.
Well, I think it looks pretty good. The taste test will come shortly,
we'll slice it up during the ad break and hand it round to the people who you know.
Anyway, ironically, I won the bet, and
amazing.
I'm cooking for you.
Well,
so.
I owe you. I feel bad about it now. Look, I'll supply some wine and something. Hey, listen, we better talk about sport. Sab, the All Blacks.
Hang on. I'm just walking I'm walking into my pantry. I could bring up. Let me have a look. I could bring up. Baked beans or tinned mints? How does that sound?
Tinned mints? Can you get tinned
I didn't even
mints?
Know there was tinned mints. Where do you
yes,
get
there is.
Who makes that? What's the label on that?
It's
budget?
Hang on a moment. It's Stag chili, classic chili with beans, and it's got mints in it as well.
Dear, oh dear.
I'm listening to that, Sam, and my mouth is watering.
Yes. Dear, oh dear. All right.
Two minutes in the French oven, the Panasonic microwave.
Is it the dynamite extra hot, Sav?
Is it the dynamite
yes,
extra
it is.
Hot?
Yeah.
Fantastic. All right, now you keep the lid on that tin, Sav. I'll stick with Guy's cooking. You've missed out, Andrew, in the ensuing ad break. We've had the slice and dice, and the nervousness involved was extraordinary because, first of all, the knife's a bit dodgy, and that's our fault because it came from our kitchen. So we were slicing through it. There was some doubt as to whether he'd gone straight through the pastry, but then having gone that, he brought his own spatula in.
Well, you can't let it crumble up.
So he pulled his spatula out of his bag, and he then went to just slice it underneath to see, and there seemed to be just momentarily a sense that maybe...
Oh, undercooked.
It had stuck onto the pan, but I can say, this is all being filmed, by the way, so it'll go out, you know, viral by about 9 o'clock this morning. It came off beautifully, absolutely beautiful.
I can't hear any puffing from Sav, so clearly it hasn't.
No, so have you given
up,
Sav?
Oh, the taste test.
No.
I'm breaking... You carry on, Sav.
I opened a tin of meat in the ad break. That'll do me. Now, is the base properly cooked, or is it a bit...
Well, we're about to find out. He's just about to have his first taste.
It's like MasterChef.
I've got to say, it's pretty bloody good. To be honest.
Thank you very much.
Can I be super honest? This isn't my kind of food.
It's a relief, I've got to be honest. No, is that right?
I don't eat this sort of food.
What are you, what's wrong?
Well, for a start, it's food, so...
I'm not big on food just generally. But that, as far as an example is concerned, is brilliantly done.
Thank you
very much. And what you want to avoid, and what you've done well, is you don't want to go deep. You don't want to go to the deep dish, because a lot of people who don't like egg don't want to go with the deep
dish.
You're onto
it.
You've gone with a fine tart, and you've got enough bacon in there to offset people who don't like the egg, and you've packed it nicely with the leeks in there as well, and you've got a nice crisp edge around with the pastry.
Sounds like I've won MasterChef. I tell you what, I could never enter a competition like that. I was pretty nervous bringing that in this morning.
Exactly, and so you should have been.
It's not exactly glowing praise, is it? It's pretty good, but it's not the food I eat.
No, well, that's not his fault. I mean, as a judge, you eat whatever's presented to you. So the fact that I don't eat this stuff doesn't really matter. The fact that it's a brilliant example of what he's done. Execution's the key.
Stick to your tendermints, Seth.
Yeah, exactly.
Would you be driving home past Whole Foods to get some colonic blow on the way home? Mike?
The Mike Hosking Breakfast, 6 to 9 weekdays on Newstalk ZB.